wabarakatuh. Before I want to start in the talk today is about what the Muslim situation with the non-Muslim people, if you have a neighbor's friend like this one and the job partner, what the Islam ahkam between the Muslim and non-Muslim, the life, because we're living with people, they are our neighbors, they are your friend, you know them, they are your partner in the job. So like this one, we inshallah talk about this ahkam in this khutbah inshallah. And before anything, the sad news also for the UK and the people in this country, about the Queen Elizabeth, she passed away. With my side and the Muslim people in this country and the certain community, we are expressing our deepest condolences to the Queen's family and the people of the UK and around the world. After that, because some of the questions I have at his brother, they were asking about the ahkam. So we'll talk inshallah about here, what is the Muslim situation like this one. Inshallah, we'll talk about this one in this khutbah. Wait. Last one is. This one. No, it's right there. The first, we know Sharia al-Islam. Islam is not only the religion we have to follow in masjid and our house. It's the complete rule for the Muslim. For the Muslim in his family, for the government, for the our life, in anything. Dunya wal akhira. So that's the Islam rules for us. The first one, the Islam, you know, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Kareem, لا إكراه في الدين. قد تبين الرشد من الغي فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم. This ayah is declared. We don't need to ask about anything else. Allah subhanahu said, لا إكراه في الدين. We not want to the freedom of the aqidah and of the iman. So is it for every people who want to believe to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can't believe. He don't want to believe, he have to be give his answer in the qiyamah when Allah subhanahu ask it, why you don't believe it and know. And also Allah said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأعطيت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today this completed the Sharia and I happy the Islam is your religion. Finish for all people. ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين. Who is didn't follow this with Islam, so is for آخرة from خاسرين. No any benefit, any another religion didn't help him. So now who was whose situation, how much is high or down or rich or poor, that is not helping anything. Who is believed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has a Jannah. And who is not believed to the Allah, he has to give an answer in the Qiyamah, why or no. So Allah forgive him. If no, no, is no our job. In this life, we believe the Islam is the Sharia. Everybody should be follow this one. Who didn't follow this one, he have to find some excuse for the Allah. If it's excuse, for example, he can't hear about anything about Islam. He was baby, he passed away. Yes, he was living in some, like the Amazon, some area they're living, nobody can give for them the news about Islam. He has between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the people, they have a knowledge, they listen, they have to find the reasons why they didn't believe to this Sharia. Because the Islam, he's believed to the Muslim, he's believed to the Isa alayhi salam, believed to Musa alayhi salam, and to Ibrahim, we are. Any Muslim believe to all of them. So the Sharia to Islam is come after the Musa and the Isa alayhi salam, like the Isa alayhi salam come to correct the Jews when after the Musa alayhi salam. So the Islam has come after the Isa alayhi salam to correct all the Sharia before the Islam. The first one, the freedom of the aqidah, they believe. So is we Islam no press anybody, you have to be Muslim. But if you don't want to believe, you and between you and the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can find in all the Islamic time, the when was a Khalafa al-Islamiyah, you can't find any news or any one time the government pushed the people, you have to believe to this religion. Is what the freedom first time Islam started. No, now we in 2002, at that time we're looking for the freedom of the people. 1,100 years ago, Islam started the freedom of the people. They want to believe, they didn't want to believe. And they have their right. But who is have a right is the life in this dunya. The freedom of the akhara is between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this life, we never can press anybody. You have to believe to Islam, we have to be Christian, and غير ذلك. The next one is Adam al-Dhulm. oppression. So in Islam is haram. Nabi Salam in Hadith Qudsi said, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي فلا تظالم. The dhulm is haram for me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it's haram for me. So don't do the dhulm between each one. So is a Muslim have to, anybody has to be safe for his dhulm, Muslim or no Muslim. So everybody is safe. The our Sharia, we are not doing any depressing anybody. No any dhulm for in each one of the people. And also the ihsan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Kareem, لَا يَنَحَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ أَنْ تَبَرُّوا وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't mind. The people, they're not fighting with you because you're Muslim. The people, they are not fighting with you because you're Muslim. You be good with them. You be good with them. Maybe your neighbors, your somebody know him, anyone. So in Islam, if no fighting with your religion, with your deen, so is allowed. You can be good with them. And we can find this one, it said the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, the ihsan ila walidin, maybe we are born and the parents, they are Muslim. But if someone is convert to the Islam, his parents, he no Muslim. Someone convert to the Islam, his mom, sister, brother, children, they don't convert to the Islam. And before that happened for the Sahaba, we didn't be before the situation they live it, because we are born from the, maybe we are far and can't understand, accept this one properly because we learn born in family, Muslim family. So when you put yourself in the situation, the Sahaba time, Abu Bakr, I don't know, for example, he was Muslim and his son, no Muslim. In the Ghazwat al-Badr, Abu Bakr was looking, where is my son? Because the mushrik, I have to kill him because he's fighting with the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was loved the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than his son. And when after he converted to the Islam, the Abu Bakr and Hassan, he said that I find it many time choice in the Ghazwat al-Badr to kill you. But because you was my dad, I didn't do this one. Abu Bakr said, I was looking out many times to find you because you my son. Why are you fighting with the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So subhanAllah is between the Muslim and no Muslim is the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't have any enemy with anybody. If somebody and if our religion enemy, that time is the different. And ihsan ila walidayna kufar, we said, and Allah in the Quran said, وَإِنْ جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَنْ تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا وَاتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ مَنْ أَنَابَ إِلَيْهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if your parents try to keep you back to their religion or push you, you have to be followed to the shirk, for this case, not follow him. But at same time, they push you, you have to follow their religion or go do the shirk, and same time you have to be good with them. Al-birr wal-ihsan, the good deeds with the parents, kindly, with the love, that is that your parents is Muslim or no Muslim, is all of them the same. If you want to spend the money to support your parents, if your parents was Muslim or no Muslim, is the same. It's your responsibility. The Sharia is allowed it. So look, because the Sharia of Islam is for the life for any time. No meaning when the Muslim have a power and that time you know the freedom from the people, by the time you is weak. No, not looking you weak or you in power. So anytime is the Sharia for any Muslim, each one of the Muslimin. Also Allah and Sahih al-Bukhari and Aslam to Abu Bakr, she said, he asked the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my mom, she's come to ask me, she's need my love, she's need, I look after her, is allowed for me to help my mom, but she's not Muslim. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, help him. So therefore, his meaning is, saying we have a responsibility for our parents, Muslim. If somebody's parents, they are no Muslim, also we have the responsibility, we have to be kind and good with them. Al-ihsan al-jiran ghayl muslimin. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talked about the neighbor's rights. And also the hadith has come, the Sahaba said, we were scared, maybe the neighbors, he got the earth, the wealth from the Muslim, for his neighbors. Because how, for example, when somebody passed away, the children and the family, they are have an earth in Islam. We have ayatul Sharia for the miras, for the wealth.
So Nabi Salam was talking about the neighbors, how much they had a right. The Sahaba said he was thinking, if somebody died, passed away, maybe like his children, family, wife, children, maybe neighbors is one of the people, they can have a right in this and his wealth. And also Nabi in Bukhari, Imam Bukhari, he's given his hadith in Adab al-Mufrad, he said, and Mujahid, كنت عند عبد الله بن عمرو عبد الله بن عمرو بن عاص رضي الله عنه he stole the sheep and he said for them start the give the meat for the our neighbors and Jewish one because it was first one next to them next door to the عبد الله بن عمرو بن عاص he said start with the Jewish one our neighbors for their family one said أصلحك الله الله يجيب يدايا why you need like this one we have a lot of the Muslim neighbors he said and Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said for us and you have to be good with our neighbors and also in Sharia is allowed to pay for your sadaqa no for zakat no for kafarat no for fidya for the sadaqa anything is the no wajib we can pay you help your neighbors if of anybody you know he's no Muslim but he's poor he need help you can help him And also is allowed from udhiyah, udhiyah, qurbani, udhiyah. This one is in Islam between the fuqaha, different opinion, but is the more in the jumhur is not the wajib, is the sunnah. So is allowed you give from the qurbani or the udhiyah meat for your neighbors if you know Muslim, because the sahaba time or the tabi'in they done. So meaning all they are we doing because to show the people and our religion, our sharia is the kind. His right to be keep. We all live together because yes, and same time we're following our Sharia, our Deen. And maybe you ask me a question. Look, how much we have tried to be good, but you now and same time you can't pray for them. Allah forgive him because this one he didn't believe to the to your Jannah. They're asking somebody my question: why we don't have to pray for Fulan? He passed away or she passed away. That's one passed away. Why I can't ask the Allah Subhanahu wa Taala forgive him? Fulan passed away, Allah forgive him. If you go your neighbors for the someone, your friend, he passed away, or maybe your family. Some about their marriage with the woman, they are no Muslim. Okay. Is allowed you marriage with them, is allowed you enjoy your life, is allowed to have children for them, and that's time. Why is not allowed to ask him for the Jannah? Because is Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in hadith said, I ask the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To do the istighfar for my mom. Allah didn't allow me this one. He said, no. But he said for me, you can visit his grave. So he allowed the Muslim to the grave, go to the grave. Is no Muslim or Muslim, but is not allowed to do the prayer for them that Allah forgive him or no. So it's not meaning with which situation we're living and who is the passed away, his friend who is far, we can be with their family after them. For Taziyah and what was the word? Condolence, yeah. You can tell him this one, but not we can't do this, tell him Allah forgive him. Because a Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi can't do it for his parents. Who know anybody for us? Know anybody in the Muslim heart more than the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi will love him than anyone, of course his family is the top one in our heart. In our heart. So if we can't do the prayer for the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam family, Ibrahim Alayhi Salam, the Azar, he's that, he didn't believe. We can't say Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala forgive the Ibrahim Alayhi Salam that. You have any dua like this one? You hear any hadith before? Yeah. No. We can't do this, say forgive the Ibrahim Alayhi Salam that or the Ibrahim Rasulullah Salam parents. Or the Sahaba parents, they all passed away and they don't believe Islam. Like the Abu Talib. How much he helped the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But never we have any dua, Allah forgive Abu Talib. And he supported the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So the meaning the Muslim have it too. We respect everybody what he believe. And we have to be kind with them until they know enemy in our religion. Is the Sharia rule. Is the Sharia opinion. Is the ulama understanding about the Sharia. And also in Islam, is allowed for us to eat the meat for the what thing is Islam, for example, cow, sheep, camel, like this one is halal, we eat. So same one is halal, you eat from the non-Muslim, from the Al-Kitab. If was a Christian, if they are, was Jewish, if they done this meat in the right, because the salted the animals, barakallah fik. Yes, this one is to be in Sharia way, and they have in their religion you have to go no with the electric shock or no to this one. So it meaning is allowed if was no Muslim. If he said Bismillah, said Allahu Akbar, read Allah is. No, if you now is okay, if no, it also is allowed to eat. But at the same time, if no, if the Muslim done a zabiha with all name of the Allah or given with electric shock, is no halal, is what Muslim or no Muslim? So, and also the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Al-Yawma uhilla lakum al-tayyibatu wa ta'amu al-ladhina utul kitaba hillun lakum wa ta'amukum hillun lahum wal muhsanatu min al-mu'minati wal muhsanatu min al-ladhina utul kitaba min qablikum. Al-Yawm is the, today is the halal for you to eat from the meat for the Nasara and Jews. And also they allow to marriage with the woman if they are adultery, yani they are clean, they are tayyiba. No is doing for looking for the zina. So the one of the shirk of the is the marriage with the non-Muslim and also the Muslim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, At-tayyibatu li-tayyibina wa tayyibina li-tayyibat. والخبيثات والخبيثين والخبيثون الخبيثات is not allowed the Muslim man he now this woman for example doing the fahsha and the zina you have to marry him he was Muslim or no Muslim because it's haram to marry with a woman and you now and also the boy the man is not allowed for the sister she's now the man he's doing the zina and the fahsha to marry with this one because it's haram because no clean this one maybe he's Muslim and same case for the Muslim and no Muslim is same. Is allowed to marry with a woman who's no Muslim if it's Christian or Jewish, but at the same time she has to be clean, no the fahsha, no the zina. And also same shart is for the Muslim woman and the Muslim man also. And the last one, I just want to tell you, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a history, he had one neighbor, is a Jewish. He was in the end of the life. He come visit him. He came Nabi Sallam to visit the Jewish neighbors he has. And also, and he has one, this boy, it was a young boy, this was helping the Nabi Sallam. He was working for Nabi Sallam in his house. And he yakhdam Nabi Sallam. Al-Khidmah is meaning someone to help the Nabi Sallam for anything. For example, that some people they was need help, somebody work and their house. So this Jewish, he was working for Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he visited when the time he was end of the life, and Nabi Sallam asked for them, say la ilaha illallah, and the boy he was looking his dad face, and he said, listen to the Abu Qasim, listen to to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he converted to the Islam. So meaning the character of the Muslim, he's the one of part of da'wah. No, only I took him. The one of the part of the da'wah you want to show the your religion, the Sharia is the right, and is for any time is the character of the Muslim. Barakallahu fikum. Yeah, Azan. Yeah, you can. You can do the Azan. You can do the Azan because things. You can, if you want to read the Sunnah, you can read them. Yeah. So if brother, you can move a little front. You have two space here, and brother, they are standing outside. Yeah, Jazakallah khair.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه واشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وخليله وصفته من خلقه صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله حق التقوى واعلموا أن إسادكم على النار لا تقوى أما بعد فإن أحكام الإسلام قد جاءت شاملة ومناسبة لجميع نواحي الحياة وصالحة لكل زمن ومكان إن مبادئ الإسلام أعلى على كل مبادئ والقيم الذي وضعها الناس من عند أنفسهم لأن مبادئ الإسلام تشريع من لدن حكيم عليم بما يصلح الناس في الدنيا والآخرة وهذا ظاهر لكل منصف وهذا ظاهر لكل منصف تأمل أحكام الإسلام فالشريعة الإسلامية المباركة هي عدل الله ورحمته سبحانه بين جميع عباده وهنا من حقوق وأحكام التعامل مع غير المسلمين حرية العقيدة. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم. قال إمام ابن كثير رحمه الله يقول الله تعالى لا إكراه في الدين أي لا تكره أحدا على الدخول في الإسلام فإنه بين واضح جلي دلالة وبرهان وبراهين لا يحتاج إلى أن يكره أحد على الدخول فيه. الثاني عدم الظلم غير المسلمين. قال سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين لله شهداء بالقسط ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعمل. وقوله ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا فإنه يقول ولا يحملنكم عداوة قوم على ألا تعدلوا في حكمكم فيهم. والثالث الإحسان إلى غير المسلمين. قال تعالى لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم إن الله يحب المقسطين. قال ابن جرير الطبري رحمه الله لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين من جميع أصناف الملل والنحل والأديان والأديان أن تبروهم وتصلوهم وتقسطوا إليهم. الإحسان إلى الوالدين الكافرين. إن شريعتنا الغراء لا تهمل إحسان الوالدين ولو كان كافرين فضلا عن والدين العاصيين. وقد حثنا القرآن العظيم بأسلوب رائع بليغ على بر الوالدين وإن كان مشركين على أن تكون هذه المعاملة طيبة سببا في هدايتهما. قال الله عز وجل وإن جاهداك على أن تشرك بي ما ليس لك به علم فلا تطعهما وصاحبهما في الدنيا معروفا واتبع سبيل من أناب إليه. ورواه شيخان عن أسماء بن أبي بكر رضي الله عنه قالت قدمت علي أمي وهي مشركة في أهد قريش إذ أعادهم يعني لما كنا بين النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وبين قريش معاهدة فاستفتيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سألت رسول الله فقلت يا رسول الله قدمت علي أمي وهي راغبة يعني هي تريد إحساني أفأصل أمي؟ قال نعم صلي أمك يعني كني محسنا إليها. ثم الإحسان للجيران لغير المسلمين. كان جيران نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بالمدينة وما حولها أصحاب ديانات مختلفة فكان منهم اليهود والنصارى والمشركين الذين يعبدون الأصنام وعلى الرغم من ذلك كان يدعوهم إلى الله تعالى بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة ولم يجبرهم على الدخول في الإسلام ولم يعتدي على حرماتهم وأموالهم وترك لهم الحرية العبادة مع أن المسلمين كانوا أصحاب الكلمة العليا في المدينة ولم يسفك دم أحد منهم بغير حق وكذلك فعل أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع جيرانهم مع غير المسلمين. رواه البخاري في أدب المفرد عن مجاهد قال كنت عند عبد الله بن عمرو بن عاص وغلامه يسرق شاة فقال يا غلام إذا فرغت فابدأ بجارنا اليهودي. فقال رجل من القوم اليهودي أصلحك الله؟ قال إني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوصي بالجار. ذبائح الكتاب. يجوز للمسلم أن يأكل من ذبائح الكتاب اليهود أو النصارى وهي التي يحل أكلها شرعا من الإبل والبقر والغنم والدواجن بشرط أن يتم ذبحها على طريقة الإسلامية وذلك باستخدام آلة الذبح كالسكين وغير ذلك. وإذا لم نعلم حال الذابح من أهل الكتاب هل ذكر اسم الله على ذبيحة أم لا فذبيحته حلال لأن الله تعالى قد أباح لنا أكل الذبيحة التي يذبحها اليهودي والنصارى والنصراني. قال سبحانه اليوم أحل لكم الطيبات وطعام الذين أوتوا الكتاب حل لكم وطعامكم حل لهم والمحسنات من المؤمنات والمحسنات من الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم إذا آتيتموهن أجورهن محصنين غير مسافحين ولا متخذي أخدان ومن يكفر بالإيمان فقد حبط عمله وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين. روى ابن جرير أن شعبي في قولي والمحسنات من الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم أي إحصانها يعني أن تغسل من الجنابة وأن تحصن فرجها من الزنا. إهداء غير المسلمين من الأضاحي، يجوز إعطاء غير المسلمين من لحوم الأضاحي لفقرهم أو لقرابتهم أو لجوارهم أو تأليفا لقلوبهم، بالشرط أن لا يكونوا محاربين لنا في ديننا. أيضا حرمة الدماء والأموال غير المسلمين. روى بخاري عن عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من قتل معاهدا لم يرح رائحة الجنة وإن ريحها توجد من مسيرة 40 عاما. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على عظم نعمه وامتنانه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وخليله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسانه إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، فاتقوا الله عباد الله حق التقوى واستمسكوا من الإسلام بالعروة الوثقى، هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في معاملة مع غير المسلمين. إن الله تعالى قد أرسل نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بالهدى ودين الحق والرسالة الإسلامية الخاتمة، فكان رحمة للعالمين. ولقد كانت دولة إسلامية في عهد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رحمة وأمانا للناس جميعا، فعاش اليهود والنصارى بجوار المسلمين آمنين على أنفسهم وأموالهم وأماكن عبادتهم، وكان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعرض عليهم الدخول في الإسلام بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة، ولم يجبر أحدا منهم على الدخول في الإسلام. رواه البخاري عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان عنده غلام يهودي يخدم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فمرض، فأتاه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوديه فقعد عند رأسي فقال: أسلم. فنظر إلى أبيه وهو عنده فقال له: اطلع ابن أبو القاسم، يعني اسمع لابن أبو القاسم، فأسلم. فخرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو يقول: الحمد لله الذي أنقذه من النار. ما دعا له، وإن بعدما أسلم، مع أنه كان من خادمه، ما دعا له بالمغفرة. لا يجوز ندعو بأي واحد لا ما آمن بالله سبحانه وتعالى بالوحدانية أن ندعو له بالمغفرة مهما كان، وإنما دعا له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعدما أسلم. وهكذا كان حسن معاملة صلى الله عليه وسلم مع جار يهودي سبباً في دخوله في الإسلام. هدايا غير المسلمين، يجوز للمسلم أن يقبل هدايا من غير المسلمين أو يرسل إليهم هدايا تأليفاً لقلوبهم. أهدى المقوقس حاكم مصر أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أم إبراهيم القبطية، واسمها كان ماريا، وأختها معها واسمها سيرين، وهي أم عبد الرحمن بن حسن بن ثابت، وغلاماً اسمها مأيور، وبغلة قال اسمها دلدل أو كذا، وكسوة وقدحا من القوارير كان يشرب فيه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. إذن الماريا القبطية هي كان أحداه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وغير مسلم، والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وافق على هذا الهدية. أمر الإسلام إتباعه بالإحسان إلى الجار، وحرم إذاه بشيء ولو كان جار غير مسلم. ولنا في رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أسوة حسنة، حيث كان له جار يهودي وكان يعوده إلى مرضه، وحدد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حقوق الجار. فعن ابن هزم ان حكيم عن ابيه عن جدي قال قلت يا رسول الله ما حق جاري علي؟ قال: ان مرض عدته، ان ذهبت الى زيارته، وان مات شيعته، ذهبت للتعزيه، وان استقرضك اقرضته، اذا طلب منك مالا لقرض تعطي له القرض، وان اعز سترته، اذا فعل شيئا خطا تستر عليه، وإن أصابه خير هنأته، إذا حصل له خيرا تقول بالتهنية، وإذا أصابه مصيبة عزيته بالتعزية، ولا ترفع بناءك فوق بنائه فتسد عليه الريح، لا ترفع بيتك كثيرا حتى تمنع الشمس أو الريح عن بيت جيرانك. وذهب بعض العلم أن للمسلم تعزية غير المسلم إذا مات له قريب، ويقول في تعزيته إن كان الميت غير المسلم ما يجوز مثل قوله: أخلفك الله خيرا منه وأحسن عزاءكم، ولا يدعو له بالأجر، يعني بالمغفرة، ولا بالميت بالرحمة، لأنهما ليس من أهل الأجر والرحمة. وينبغي أن يقصد بذلك كله تأليف قلب غير مسلم على الإسلام، كما للمسلم أن يزور قبر غير مسلم للعظة. هذا أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم هذا وصلى الله وسلم على بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ورضى اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي والنسائر الصحابة الأكرمين والتابعين لهم إحسان إلى يوم الدين اللهم اجعلنا من مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتنا ومن ذرياتنا وجميع المسلمين اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب رسولك وحب من يحبك اللهم ارحم بلاد المسلمين وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم احمي بلاد المسلمين وسائر بلاد وسائر المسلمين من الفتن والمحن ما ظهر منها وما بطن ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار واذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعم يزدكم وللذكر الأكبر وأقم الصلاة